Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. I'm Hashim Ali Khan. Already I have completed 9 problems on electricity company financial statements. Now in this video, I'm going to continue the problem 10th, 11th, 12th. So already if you have watched the earlier problems, definitely you got the knowledge of how to make the financial statements of electricity companies by applying the provisions of Electricity Companies Act. So already I have explained you in detail regarding the double account system. This system will be applied in electricity company's account. What is the meaning of the term double account system? Already I have discussed in the first video introduction part. If you have watched that part, definitely you can be able to understand what are the type of problems we have in this electricity companies. The double account system is a system of accounting in which two balance sheets are prepared. The first part of the balance sheet is called receipts and expenditure on capital account. And the second balance sheet is the general balance sheet. So that's why double account system it is called, because two balance sheets are prepared. Already so many problems I have solved in the previous video regarding the revenue account, net revenue account, then capital account and general balance sheet. Now we are in the second part of this topic. The second part is regarding calculation of surplus and disposal of surplus according to the provisions of Electricity Act. So if you join in the middle, you may not be able to understand. My suggestion, if you want the complete knowledge, complete command, confidence on this topic, watch the video from beginning. Don't miss the first introduction part, and the starting problems are very, very important. If you have not watched that earlier videos, you cannot be able to understand now. So I suggest you to go to the playlist of my channel, select the subject Advanced Corporate Accounting, select the topic Electricity Companies. Watch those video earlier videos, initial videos. Now you can be able to understand here. Now, 10th problem. So before starting 10th problem, I expect my viewers to have a printout of the problems, which I have given in the link under my description. So take a printout, hard copy ready before watching the video. Come on, 10th problem I'm reading out. Great Electricity Supply Limited furnishes the following information and seeks your assistance in computing the disposal of its surplus in accordance with the provisions of Electricity Supply Act 1948, particulars of the for the year ended 30th September 2010. So it is asking you to show the disposal of surplus. Surplus means clear profit minus reasonable return. Clear profit minus reasonable return will give you surplus. So how to dispose of the surplus? That's what we are going to find out. The particulars are given rupees in lakhs. Net profit before charging debenture interest. Net profit before charging debenture interest. That means we have to charge debenture interest. After debenture interest, how much is the net profit? We have to find out, and that will be the clear profit. Net profit after debenture interest is called clear profit. So fixed assets less depreciation 50 lakh is 150 lakh. Fixed assets less depreciation, that means already depreciation is deducted. It is called WDV, written down value. So this 150 lakh rupees of fixed asset, that is the WDV, written down value. But we don't require written down value, we want the original cost. So how to find out original cost? Add back the depreciation which is deducted. Depreciation deducted 50 lakh. After deducting 50 lakh, the value of the fixed assets were 150 lakh. So we add back 50 lakh, 150 plus 50. 200 lakh is the original cost of fixed asset. Next, loan from Electricity Board, deduction item. So remember, for finding out the surplus, we need reasonable return. For calculating reasonable return, we need capital base. Statement showing disposal of profit for the year ended, first we need the capital base. The capital base, we have to add a few items and subtract few items. The thing you have to remember is which are the items to be added and which are the items to be deducted. The first, fixed assets. Original cost of fixed asset we need. In the problem, WDV is given, written down value is given. The written down value of fixed asset is 150 lakh. to this we add back depreciation. So depreciation 50 lakh is added back. The original cost of fixed asset is 200 lakhs. 200 lakhs is the original cost of fixed asset. Loan from electricity board, it is a deduction item here. Loan from electricity board, 60 lakh. And one thing you remember, when we have taken original cost of fixed assets, then depreciation will be taken as a deduction item. So under deduction item, depreciation on fixed asset 50 lakh. Here we have added back 50 lakh because we need the original cost. Later on we deduct the depreciation 50 lakh. Loan from electricity board deduct. 6% investment of reserve fund. Reserve fund investment. There are two types of investment. Reserve fund investment and contingency reserve investment. Reserve fund investment will not be taken while calculating capital base. For calculating capital base, we don't require reserve fund investment. That investment will consider while calculating reasonable return, I'll tell you. Then 6% investment of contingency reserve. Now we will take investment of contingency reserve. That will be taken under addition items. Here you can see investment of contingency reserve 40 lakh. Next comes tariff and dividend control reserve. It's an item of deduction. Tariff and dividend control reserve is an item of deduction. So here tariff and dividend control reserve 4 lakh. Next comes security, customer security deposit. Again deduction item. Customer security deposit 3 lakh. Next comes customer's contribution to main lines. That means customer's contribution for fixed assets. And this customer contribution towards fixed asset will be deducted from fixed assets. Here you can see original cost of fixed asset less customer's contribution. Even in the previous problem also I told you this point. Customer's contribution will be deducted from fixed assets. Next comes preliminary expenses, it is the intangible, it is cost of intangible that will be taken under addition items. The cost of intangible preliminary expenses 2 lakh. Next comes average of current asset. The average of current asset is an addition item. The average of current asset 25 lakh. Next comes development reserve. Development reserve is a deduction item. Last one, development reserve 2 lakh. 10% debenture interest fully paid during the year 5 lakh. 10% debenture interest. That means debentures are there. What is the face value of debenture? We don't know. It is not given in the problem. That on that debenture, 10% interest comes to 5 lakh. 10% interest comes to 5 lakh. That means 50 lakh rupees is the debenture. 50 lakh ka 10% 5 lakh. If the debentures are 50 lakh, then 10% of 50 lakh will be 5 lakh. So here 10% debenture interest fully paid during the year 5 lakh. So instead of directly giving debentures, it has given interest. From interest we can calculate. If the debentures are 50 lakh, so 10% of 50 lakh comes to 5 lakh and that 5 lakh rupees is the interest. So we can say debentures are 50 lakh. So here you can see debentures are 50 lakh. Even in notes we can write like this. Debenture interest at the rate of 10% is equal to 5 lakh. Debenture interest at the rate of 10% is equal to 5 lakh. Therefore face value of debenture is equal to 5 lakh into 100 by 10 is equal to 50 lakhs. The face value of the debenture is 50 lakh, not directly given in the problem. We have calculated 50 lakh. So next, assume Reserve Bank of India rate at 8%. RBI, Reserve Bank of India, bank rate is 8%. Your working should clearly indicate the capital base, reasonable return, surplus and disposal of surplus. It is asking you to write, to calculate the capital base, reasonable return, surplus and disposal of surplus. These are the four things. First of all, the student must know how to find out the capital base. What are the items that should be taken for calculating capital base? Again, I have repeated so many times in the previous video. Again, I'm telling you, first you should take the original cost of fixed asset. In our problem, original cost is not given, WDV is given. After deducting depreciation, 150 is given. We should not deduct, we add back. So 150 plus 50, 200 is the original cost. But customers have contributed towards fixed asset, so deduct. Then intangible, cost of intangible assets, example, preliminary expenses. Average of monthly current asset and investment on for contingency reserve or contingency reserve investment. Four items. These four items are added. Deduction item. The first deduction item always will be depreciation. Depreciation of fixed assets, 50 lakh. Second point, loan from electricity board. That is also a deduction item. Third one, debentures. Then tariff and dividend control reserve, development reserve, security deposit from customers. That's all. So these are the items of deduction. You have to remember these items. Every problem will come across these only. So A is the total of addition items, B is the total of deduction items. A minus B will give you capital base 96 lakhs. Now second part will calculate reasonable return. In reasonable return, again, you have to remember 5 points. Every problem you'll get 5 points. The first point is return on capital base at the bank rate plus 2%. Return on capital base at the bank rate plus 2%. These are the provisions given by Electricity Companies Act. So capital base already we got in 96 lakh. On this 96 lakh bank rate, in the problem it is given, the bank rate is 8% in our present problem. So 8 plus 2, 10. So whatever is the bank rate, to bank rate we add 2% more according to the provisions of Electricity Act. So 10% of 96 lakh, you will get 9,60,000. Second, income from reserve fund investment. Two types of investment I told you, contingency reserve investment and reserve fund investment. Contingency reserve investment, that will be taken here. Whereas income on reserve fund investment, that will be taken here. So in the problem itself, it is given 6% investment of reserve fund 45 lakh. It is given 6% investment of reserve fund 45 lakh. So 45 lakh into 6%, 2,75,000. Then 0.5% on loan from electricity board. So loan from electricity board, here you are having 60 lakh. So 0.5% means 0.5. So 0.5% of 60 lakh, 30,000. Then 0.5% on debentures. The debentures are 50 lakh, already we know it. So 0.5%, 0.5% of 50 lakh, 25,000. 0.5% on development reserve. Development reserve is 2 lakh. So 2 lakh into 0.5%, 1,000. That's all. So 5%. What are the 5%? First, return on capital base. Second, income on reserve fund investment. Third, 0.5% on loan from state electricity board. Then 0.5% on debentures. 0.5% on development reserve. That's it. Make the calculations. Take the total reasonable return we got, 12,86,000. This is RR, reasonable return. Now, calculation of surplus. Next part. First part, capital base. Second part, reasonable return. Third part, surplus. So, profit. Profit as given in the problem, 18,50,000. But this 18,50,000 is before interest on debentures. But we want after interest on debentures. So how much is the interest paid on debentures? 5 lakh. So deduct 5 lakh from 18,50,000. 13,50,000 is called clear profit. Clear profit. From clear profit, deduct the reasonable return. Reasonable return of 12,86,000. Deduct 12,86,000. Surplus 64,000. Surplus is 64,000. So three parts completed. We have shown capital base, we have shown reasonable return, and we got to the surplus. Last and final item, disposal of surplus. How to dispose of this surplus? So, Electricity Companies Act says, if the surplus is below 5% of RR, below 5% of reasonable return. Reasonable return, how much? 12,86,000. 12,86,000 into 5%, you are getting 64,300. 64,300 is the 5% of RR, whereas actual surplus is only 64,000. That means our surplus is below 5% of RR. In that case, the surplus will be disposed of in this way. What is the method? 1/3 of surplus. How much is the surplus here? 64,000. So 1/3 of surplus, free use of the company. It is called free reserve. The Electricity Companies Act says 1/3 of 64,000 will be for any use by the company. Company can use for any purpose. So 1/3 of 64,000, 21,333.33. Remaining balance. Remaining balance ka 0.5. 0.5 means half. Half will be transferred to tariff and dividend control reserve, and remaining half will be transferred to consumer benefit reserve. In other words, we can say 1/3 of 64,000. 1 by 3 of 64,000. 64,000 divided by 3. 21,333. This is transferred to, this is free use of the company. Now we deduct 64,000 minus 21,333.333. So you are getting 42,666.6666. The balance after deducting 21,333, remaining balance is 42,666.6666. Half of this amount. Half. So divided by 2. Is 21,333, same amount. So same 21,333 will be transferred to tariff and dividend control reserve. Remaining half will be transferred to consumer benefit reserve. In this way, the surplus will be distributed. Remember, these provisions will be applied only if the surplus is below 5% of RR. In our problem, 5% of RR is 64,700. But we are getting 64,000 surplus. The surplus is below 5% of RR. So disposal of surplus will be like this. That's all. So this is the end of problem number 10. Come on, now we'll start the next problem. Problem number 11. From the following particulars about Bijal Power Limited, determine the capital base, reasonable return, the disposal of surplus. Just like the previous problem, first we have to calculate capital base, a reasonable return, and disposal of surplus. The amount particulars, tariff and dividend control reserve. First of all, we are going to calculate the capital base. See, calculation of capital base, addition item, subtraction item. The one by one item you have to remember. The first item is given tariff and dividend control reserve. It's a deduction item. So here I have taken tariff and dividend control reserve, 65 lakh. Then reserve fund investment at par. So reserve fund investment income, that will be taken in reasonable return. While calculating reasonable return, we take income from reserve fund investment. Then contingency reserve investment. Contingency reserve investment is an addition item. So here you can see contingency reserve investment here. Investment against contingency reserve, 73,15,000. Development reserve is a deduction item. So development reserve, 32,50,000. Loan from electricity board, deduction item. Loan from electricity board, 2,11,25,000. Then preliminary expenses, it is cost of intangible. It will be taken under addition item. The cost of intangibles, preliminary expenses, 6 lakh. Next, security deposit from customers, it's a deduction item. Security deposit from customers, 50 lakh. Next comes customers' contribution towards fixed asset. So it will be deducted from original cost of fixed asset. The original cost of fixed asset, from that we deduct amount contributed by customers 8 lakh. So I'll tell you how we got this original cost of fixed asset. Right now you remember contribution from customers will be deducted. Next comes average, monthly average of current assets. It's an addition item. So monthly average of current assets, 1 crore 10 lakh minus 30 lakh. How 30 lakh? That is the debtors, I'll tell you. Then next page it is given, debentures. Debentures are 5 crore. Debentures is a deduction item. So debentures 5 crore. Next comes fixed assets. Now you see, fixed assets 16 crore 25 lakh. Net of depreciation 3 crore 25 lakh. Net of depreciation 3.25 crore. That means after deducting 3.25 crore, the fixed assets are 16 crore 25 lakh. So this 16 crore 25 lakh rupees is the WDV, written down value after deducting depreciation. So we add back depreciation. So depreciation 3.25 crore add kar denge. So 16 crore 25 lakh rupees WDV plus depreciation 3.25 crore. Dono ko add kar do, original cost of fixed asset will be 19 crore 50 lakh. Original cost of fixed asset. From this we deduct amount contributed by customers. Next, profit earned 3 crore 15 lakh net after debenture interest at 15%. That means after debenture interest already deducted. After deducting debenture interest, the net profit is 3 crore 15 lakh. This is the clear profit. This is the clear profit. This will make use for calculating surplus. Now, monthly average of current assets includes due from customer 30 lakh. Monthly average of current asset is given 1 crore 10 lakh. This 1 crore 10 lakh includes amount due from customers or debtors. That will be deducted. This 30 lakh rupees will be deducted. So here 1 crore 10 lakh minus 30 lakh will get 80 lakh rupees monthly. Then reasonable return calculated to be done at 12%. This is the bank rate. That's all. All the points in the problem I have explained. Now we'll calculate capital base. Original cost of fixed asset. So WDV plus depreciation is the original cost. From that we deduct amount contributed by customers. Then cost of intangible preliminary expenses, investment against contingency reserve, monthly average of current assets excluding amount due from customers, debtors. The debtors amount should be deducted. Then total is 21 crore 1 lakh 15 thousand. That is the addition item. Subtraction. Depreciation 3.25. Here depreciation we have added back to calculate the original cost. Now depreciation should be deducted. So 3 crore 25 lakh. Loan from electricity board 2 crore 11 lakh 25 thousand. Debentures 5 crore. Security deposit from customers 50 lakh. Tariff and dividend control reserve 65 lakh given in the problem. Development reserve 32 lakh 50 thousand. Take the total of deduction item 11 crore 83 lakh 75 thousand. Now A addition items, B deduction items. A minus B capital base 9 crore 17 lakh 40 thousand. First part completed. Now I am coming to the second part, that is reasonable return. It's very easy. 5 points you have to remember. The first is return on capital base at bank rate plus 2%. So capital base already we got it here. On this bank rate, in the problem bank rate is given 12%. Last line it is given bank rate 12%. Add up 2%, it will become 14%. So 14% of 9 crore 17 lakh 40 thousand. You will get 1 crore 28 lakh 43 600. This is the return on capital base. Now, income from reserve fund investment. It is given in the problem. The reserve fund investment are 81 lakh 25 thousand and the return is 8%. It is given in the problem. So calculate 6 lakh 50 thousand. Now half percent, 0.5% on loan from electricity board. Loan from electricity board is 2 crore 11 lakh 25 thousand into 0.5%. 1 lakh 5,625. Half percent on debentures. So debentures are 5 crore. So half percent, 0.5% of 5 crore, 2,50,000. Half percent on development reserve. Development reserve is 32,50,000. Half percent, 16,250. So remember, 5 items are there in reasonable return. The first, return on capital base. Second, income from reserve fund investment. Then half percent, half percent, half percent. half percent on loan from electricity board, half percent on debentures, and half percent on development reserve. That's it. The reasonable return we got 1,38,65,475. Reasonable return we got. Now we'll find out the surplus. Surplus means clear profit minus RR, reasonable return. Clear profit is given in the problem 3,15,00,000, given in the problem. So from clear profit we subtract reasonable return 1,38,65,475. The resulting figure is surplus. We got surplus 1,76,34,525. Huge surplus is there. Now disposal of surplus. See, disposal. First of all, four things we have to calculate: A, B, C, D. Now see, concentrate here. First one, 20% of RR, reasonable return. So RR already we got it 1,38,65,475. Now 20% of this RR, 27,73,095. Put it as A. Call it as A. What is A? 20% of RR. Second point, 5% of RR. RR already we got it here. The 5% calculate 6,93,274. Call it as B. So A, 20% of RR. B, 5% of RR. Now C, 1/3 of A. 1/3 of A. What is A here? 27,73,095. So 1/3 of 27,73,095, you'll get 9,24,375. 3 points. First point, A, 20% of RR. B, 5% of RR. C, 1/3 of A. A, B, C we have calculated. Now D, what is D? B or C, whichever is lower will be treated as D. Will be treated as D, and that is for free use of the company. That amount will be free use for the company, electricity company. So here B or C, B is 6,93,274 and C is 9,24,375. Whichever is lower, which is lower here? 6,93,000. So this 6,93,274 will be called as D, right? And B or C, whichever is lower, is free for use of the company. 6,93,274. Now, surplus minus A. Surplus minus A. How much is the surplus here? 1,76,34,525. Minus A. A is 27,73,000. And this surplus minus A will be transferred to consumer benefit reserve. Consumer benefit. What is that? Surplus minus A. This should be transferred to consumer rebate reserve. Now, A minus D. Calculating A minus D. A is first one, 20%. D is this one, free use. D is free use. So A minus D, 27,73,095. Minus 6,93,274. A minus D. How much you got? 20,79,821. This is A minus D. Now 50% of A minus D will be transferred to tariff and dividend control reserve, and remaining 50% transferred to consumer benefit reserve. A minus D. After calculating A minus D, half transferred to tariff and dividend control reserve, and half transferred to consumer benefit reserve. So 50% of A minus D, 50% of 20,79,821, that comes to 10,39,911. This is transferred to consumer benefit reserve. Now remaining 50%, 50% of A minus D, 50% of 20,79,821, 10,39,910, this is transferred to tariff and dividend control reserve. That's all. Now final disposal. Three things we have to transfer. The surplus will be transferred to tariff and dividend control reserve. The surplus will be transferred to consumer benefit reserve. The surplus will be transferred to free use of the company. These are the three things, three areas where surplus will be disposed of. First of all, transfer to tariff and dividend control reserve. Here you can see, transfer to tariff and dividend control reserve, 10,39,910. So 10,39,910. This is the amount transferred to tariff and dividend control. Second, transfer to consumer benefit reserve. two times we have transferred to consumer benefit reserve. See here, this amount should be transferred to consumer benefit reserve. This is the first point. 1,48,61,430 transferred to consumer benefit reserve. Again, we have transferred here. 10,39,911 transferred to consumer benefit reserve. So two times we have transferred to consumer benefit reserve. We add 1,48,61,430 plus 10,39,911. Add up both 1,59,01,341. This is the total amount transferred to consumer benefit reserve. Lastly, for any use of the company, free use of the company, that is D. Free use of the company, 6,93,274. That's all. If you add up these three amount, you must get the surplus. What is the surplus here? 1,76,34,525. 1,76,34,525. This is the disposal of surplus. So after calculating surplus, we have to distribute between tariff and dividend control reserve, consumer benefit reserve, and free use of the company. Right? That's all. So this is the end of problem number 11.